Welcome to Deep Core. Join me in a comfortable cross-legged seat. You might like to put something underneath your bottom to prop yourself up. And close your eyes. And land in your seat. Feel the periphery of your body, the part of you that touches the atmosphere. And then become aware of everything around the midline of your body. The bones of your spine. The organs of your belly. And then the muscles that wrap around the belly and the back body. We'll begin with Kapalabhati, fire breath. 3 rounds, 50 pulses each. Take an inhale. Let it go. Notice the afterglow, the impact. Second round, a little bit quicker. Inhale. Let it go. Again, the residue. Perhaps it's a temperature change. So this is for the transverse abdominis, the lowest layer of our bellies. Last round, inhale. Let it go. Drop your chin, let some light into the eyes. And then rolling over onto all fours. Inhale, dropping the belly, lifting the eyes. Exhale, round, squeeze your knees toward each other. Inhale, the belly drops, sink. Exhale, push the earth away. Back through neutral, take your right knee through center, send your left leg back and start to pulse the leg in the sky. So when we think of the core of the body, we might think six-pack, but the core of the body, the health of the body is top of the glutes, lower back. Couple more pulses. We just want to create a bit of a fire in the hip. And then tuck the right toes under and stand up for a three-legged dog. Take your right knee to your right armpit, protract the shoulders. Send the leg to the sky. Cross it over. Send the leg to the sky, drop that right knee to the earth, and then Taibo kick, so that left knee reaches to the left armpit, kick it out to the side, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, again, leg is high, three-legged dog, right knee, right armpit, skyward, cross it over, send it up, and then release your foot, drop down onto the knees. We'll take 3 rounds of Nali Kriya, so we're hollowing the belly back. Hands on the knees, take an inhale. Exhale, completely, hold yourself empty, lift your organs up, hold the exhale. Release your belly. Notice the residue, so more elastic slingshot back, take an inhale. Exhale, hold yourself empty, slingshot it back. Release. Final round, take an inhale. Exhale, hold yourself empty, lift the belly back, lock it. Release the belly. Meet me on all fours, take your left foot through center and then pulsing that right hip. So Nali Kriya is all about hollowing the lower belly. It's all about activating the transverse abdominis. So it's the closest core muscle to the spine. And we access it in downward dog. We access it when we're floating or stepping. Three-legged dog, tuck your left toes under, right leg up. Right knee to the right armpit. Skyward. Cross it over to the sky. Drop the left knee to the earth, Thai bow kicks. Right knee to the armpit, kick out to the side. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Three-legged dog. Eyes forward, step your right foot and your left foot forward. Inhale, lengthen. Fold in half. Stand tall, reach high, look up. Release the arm, three more rounds of Nali Kriya. At the top of the mat, goddess the legs. Hands on the knees will take three rounds. Take an inhale. Exhale completely. Hold yourself empty, lift your organs up. Release your belly. Notice if you feel uncomfortable on an exhalation, it's pretty normal, but start to extend your time there. Inhale. Exhale. Hold yourself empty, lift it up. Release. Take a breath. Final round, big inhale. Exhale completely. Hold yourself empty, lift it. Release your belly, Samasthiti. Find a drishti, a gazing point. Find a breath pattern. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, fold. Inhale, lengthen. Step walk, float back, and then dropping down onto the forearms, take a headstand base and lower and lift the pelvis. So this is activating the entire trunk of the core. So our core is how we drive the physical body. It's how we bend forward, it's how we bend back. It's responsible for picking things up. So to have a strong core is to be safe, to be versatile. Twenty more seconds. Five. Beautiful. All the way to the belly. Tops of the hands to the earth. Lift the chest and flutter kick your legs. So the tops of the glutes, it's interesting, they qualify as part of our core. The glutes are responsible for lifting the leg back. Think airplane pose. Think crescent lunge. 15 15 more seconds. Kick as though there were water behind you. And release the chest, extend back, downward dog. Take a couple moments. You might pedal your knees. You might shake your head. But that Nali Kriya, that hollowing of the belly, should be in effect. Subtle, but natural. Eyes forward, step walk, float to the top. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, fold. Stand tall, reach high, look up. Release your arms. Inhale, up. Exhale, fold. Inhale, lengthen. Step walk, float back, high plank, and then tap your right shoulder with your left hand and tap your left shoulder with your right hand. And as you do this, as though we could pull energy up through our arms into the bottom of our heart. So imagine the heart was in the center of the chest. So you're activating the fork muscles, the serratus muscles on the sides of the ribs. You're taking your low ribs to the tops of your hips, compressing the front line. 15 more seconds, and as you're crossing over, compress and side body little compression pulling in. Nice, and come all the way down. 10 lifts, arms out to the side, inhale up and down. 9, 8. So even as we backbend, strengthen the back body and the glutes is beneficial. Notice if the pelvic floor has lost any engagement and begin to bring your attention there. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. One, release the neck and shoulders, push back, downward dog. So again, it's just a couple moments here. It's not a disciplined or way too diligent dog. It's kind of laissez-faire, like a little bit, just do your thing. Eyes forward, top of the mat. Lengthen, pull your belly back. Dive forward, stand tall, reach high, release your arms. Last one, reach up, fold in, halfway lift, step walk, float back, high push up, then drop to the right forearm, the left forearm, the right palm, the left palm, and switch directions, left, then right, left, then right, alternating. And as you do it, start to get more delicate, more specific, more accurate. Accuracy is easy when you feel strong and well-rested. It's more challenging, though, when the poses become a little bit exhausting. Come all the way down onto the belly. Tops of the hands on the earth, we lift up, Shalambhasana, shoulders down the back. So as though we're weight bearing on our pelvis, pull your legs into your pelvis, take your back muscles into your pelvis, like you're coiling up a spring. And release. Push back, downward dog. Set your eyes, set your feet. So we do core work not because we care so much about what it looks like, so much as the way that it feels. We want to access elegance and freedom, both on the mat and off the mat. Eyes forward, top of the mat. Lengthen. Bow. Stand tall, reach high. Release your arms. Bending into the knees, arms up. Airplane on the right. Bring your knee to your chest, arms forward. Airplane. Knee to the chest, arms forward. Airplane. Pull it forward, find grace. Two more, forward and back and forward and back. Sit on your throne, arms up. Airplane, opposite leg. Knee to chest, arm forward. Airplane. Knee forward. So why is this core work? This is the top of the glute. This is balance, and balance is a derivative of strength and control in the belly. Two, one. Inhale, Utkatasana. Exhale, Uttanasana. Inhale, lengthen. Step walk, float back, low push-up. Spinal extension. Downward dog. Lift your right leg up. Right knee to the right armpit, protract to the sky. Step it between the hands for a crescent lunge. Go really, really low. Press out through the edge of the back foot, the big toe edge. So this is a hot pose, like literally temperature-wise, not in a sexy way. Pull the right knee forward, pull the left heel back. Beautiful. Hands down, side plank on the left. Spin it open. So this will be a 30-second hold. And what's so sweet about this is we're condensing the side of the body. So these are known as the oblique muscles. If at any point it becomes too much, step down. 10 more seconds, reach up through the top arm, compress the obliques, shorten the side body. Beautiful, hands down, eyes down, low push up. Ride it up. Strike back. Lift your left leg up. Left knee to the left armpit. To the sky. Step it between your hands for sexy pose. Hot pose. Kick out through the heel, arms up. So there's certain poses in yoga that truly create a fire. Lunging, Utkatasana. It's like the quickest way for heat. Pull the front knee forward, kick the back heel back, soften. Let your fingertips be soft, but full of intent. Couple more breaths. And then Vasisthasana, side plank on the right. Roll it open, it's 30 seconds. Again, you're going to compress the armpit, the side lung. Top arm extends up, your eyes are committed upward. Squeeze the inner ankle bones together, step your knee down if you need. 10 more seconds. Compress, isolate. Beautiful. Hands down, drop to your knees, cross your ankles, meet me in Navasana. 10 V-snaps. One. Remember when I used to do five? Man, I was a pushover back then. Five more. So they say this is probably one of the very best core exercises. And then all the way down onto your back, legs go wide, Upavishta, intertwine the fingers behind the head, lift and lower. So as you're coiling up, feel the whole six-pack muscle. Feel it compress and tighten. Rectus abdominis. So there's actually eight of them. And their responsibility is primarily to crunch. They look nice, or maybe society has decided they look nice. 30 more seconds, flex through the feet. And as we move through our core exercises, notice what your body prefers, but have an open mind about it because it could change. Halfway there, 15 more seconds. Nicely done. Legs to the ceiling. You might hook your thumbs under your hips and we'll leg lift. So this is such an interesting posture or ab exercise because you're starting to use your hip flexors. What I love about it is it's how to control your legs. So for some of you, you've got these gorgeous long legs, so it's up to you to learn how to control them through the belly, through the toes. Feel the back of the head press down into the mat so there's no wobbles and there's more integrity. Five, four, three, two, one. This next one is for the obliques. Drop your feet to the floor, lift your right leg up, cross it over, figure four. Intertwine the fingers, left elbow to the right knee, 10, nine. What's interesting about this is if there's any back or neck pain, you might get a little bit more information. Five, four, three, two, one. Untangle, retangle, 10, opposite side. So as you do this, is there a preference? Is there a side of the body that feels more connected, easier to be in? So one of the caveats to yoga is that we have to free the body. Free it from pain, free it from any feeling of dislike we might have. Four, three, two, one. Release the neck and shoulders, 10 V snaps. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Vinyasa, the feet go back. Low push up. Ride the inhale, stretch the front line. Slide back. A couple beats, notice your temperature. Feel the temperature of your naked skin against the room. And then notice the weight of your clothes on your skin unless you're totally naked. Eyes forward, top of the mat. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, bow. Sit on your throne, Utkatasana. Airplane on the left leg. Pull the arms up, pull the knee up. Airplane. Pull it up. So where is your drishti? Where is your gazing point? It's gonna shift a little as the torso bows. The gazing point is like an extra point of contact. Inhale, Utkatasana. Other side, airplane, knee up, arms up, like old school step aerobics. Three, own the leg in the sky. Really own it. Press through the toes to own it. Utkatasana. Exhale, fold. Inhale, lengthen. step, walk, float back, lower. Drag your pelvis to your wrists. Slide back. Lift your right leg up. Right knee to the right armpit. To the sky. Step it through for crescent. And then warrior two will take exalted warrior with a bind. Lift your right arm up and take your left hand and catch your left elbow. So you're extending the side of the body. Some of you might tangle your hands behind your back, but lift and extend from hip to armpit. Keep pulling the right knee toward the pinky toe. Press into the edge of the back foot so the arch is not fallen. Again, another hot pose. Nicely done, untangle. Take your right leg, send it high, then cross the right foot over the left ankle. So you're kind of crisscrossing. We'll take 5 push-ups. Take your hands a bit wider, and I want your elbows actually to wing out. 5. So that old school, or I guess what a push-up truly is. 3, 2, 1. Untangle, push back, downward dog. Lift your left leg up. Left knee, left armpit, protract to the sky. Step it through, arms up. Warrior two. So exalted with the bind, take your left elbow, catch it with the right hand. Some of you will tangle your hands, expose your lung. So remember Nali Kriya, how we held it on the exhale? Right now, could you kind of play with those pregnant pauses at the inhale and the exhale? Lunge even deeper, more fierce, hot, heat. Nicely done. Untangle, hands down. Sweep that left leg high. Cross it over. Take the hands a bit wider. 5 push-ups. Out, up. Elbows out, up. 3, 2, 1. Untangle. Drop to the knees. Cross the ankles. Meet me in a seat, 10 V snaps. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. On your back, legs up for a moment. We're gonna ride the bike, but let that settle for a beat. Ride the bike. Left elbow, right knee, and alternate. So we'll do this for 1 minute. It's 1 minute of your life. It's 60 seconds of your life. Own your legs. So we own our legs when we own our core. When we own our core values, we own our lives. What is the most important thing to you? Right now, it should be your toes, your feet. We're halfway there. You could speed it up or slow it down. Tell me about the space between your pinky toe and your fourth toe. And then tell me about the weight on your head of your fingertips. Is it a gripping, a squeezing? Are they pushing into each other? 10 more seconds. Yes. Release. Legs to the sky, leg lifts. You could support your hips. You could alternate one, then the other. So riding the bike is oblique, so it's the side of the trunk. It's the six-pack muscles. And leg lifts are the same. Although we tap into transverse abdominis, the lowest level of the belly, and also the hip flexors and the psoas. Feel the back of the head kick down. Five, four, three, two, one. Legs up, take a moment, let it land. Be at home in your body. Sometimes I can feel like a hot mess when I do core work, but stay with it. We'll ride the bike again. Ready, go. 1 minute of your life. 1 minute in that long existence of yours. And if you want time to slow, do sit-ups. Notice how the legs are moving. So if this were a dance, is the leg or your legs doing something beautiful, or is it a bit of a train wreck? And then what about the way you twist? Is it poetic? We're halfway there, stay with it. Feel the space between the big toe, second toe. 15 more seconds. Nicely done, release. Feet to the earth, lift up your hips and scoot your hips 2 inches to the left. Let the knees fall to the right, intertwine the fingers, rise and fall, 10. So this is for the obliques, those side muscles. Honestly, we use them to reach over and catch our seatbelt. We don't do it a whole lot in regular life. Five, four, three, two, one. Release the neck and shoulders, knees through center, scooch the hips 4 inches to the right. Knees fall. Let's do this. Up and down. And what's cool here is if you have a neck or a back injury, you might notice like, whew, one side feels immovable. Five, four, three, two, one. Release the neck and shoulders, knees through center. V snaps, 10 of them. Ready? One, two, three, four. We got this. Five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Vinyasa. Feet back, lower. Stretch your belly, stretch your front line. Downward dog, go back. So option one, stay. Option two, child's. Option three, forearm or handstand. So you might use a wall. You might take your child's pose. But own your legs. If we're learning anything, it's how to take control of our lives, take control of our bodies. Looking good. Reach up through those legs. Like this was your job. This was the only reason you were put on the planet. Five more breaths. Wow. Sit back. Good work. Child's pose. Forehead to the earth. Inhabit your skin. Wear your skin with pride. Rise up, all fours. Downward dog, strike back. Step walk, float to the top. Inhale, lengthen and tense your fingers or put blocks under your hands. Weight into the right foot, send the left leg back, and almost like a grandfather clock, we're gonna try to sweep it through and then sweep it back up. So you'll have to plug the top of the thigh into the pelvis, and you might even have to hang a bit to the left. Tick tock, tick tock. Flexing the foot, feel the full range of motion. Nice, okay, so from here, lean into that left hand, left foot, catch your right big toe or knee and take it out to the side. Widen the glutes, so it's kind of like a Prasarita balancing on one foot. Widen the thighs, take them back behind you. Use the toe into the hand to find a line. So if there's a bend in the knee, it's going to be really hard to balance. Nicely done, release that foot. Take a moment, let it surrender, and then set yourself up for grandfather clock on the other side. Tent the fingers or hands to blocks. Weight into the right foot, send the left leg back, and then tick-tock, pull it forward. And get exploratory through the range of motion. So it's kind of interesting to know where we might be strong, where we might be weak, where there might be like a little glitch. Five, four, three, two, one, and then once it's down, weight into the right hand, right foot, catch your left toe, go wide, or your knee. If there's a little bit of burn, awesome. Lift it nice and high, big full breath, widen the thighs, stay with me. Couple more breath, wider, wider, wider. Release your hand, release your foot. Inhale, lengthen. Bow. Bakasana crow pose or a little squat. Pick it up like we're loading a spring, so you can make yourself into a teeny weeny little package, or if you like to lift up and protract the shoulders. Three, two, one, fly back. Lower. Stretch your belly, lift your heart. Downward dog. Lift your right leg up. Right knee to the right armpit. To the sky. Step it between your hands, arms up. Right arm back, left arm forward. Take your right hand to your back thigh. Revolved exalted warrior. Kick out through the left heel, pull forward through the right knee. Another hop pose, like we could splay those legs. Three, two, one. Hands to the earth. It's a runner stretch or a split. Before we move into our last little push of core. Soft eyes. Inhabit your skin, wear it. Get so comfortable in who you are that everyone that's near you feels better in their skin. Nicely done, returning to a lunge and then step back, down dog. Left leg lifts. Left knee to the left armpit, protract. To the sky. Step it between the hands, kick out through the back heel, arms up. Right arm forward, left arm back. Take your left hand to your right thigh, pull the knee forward, kick back through the back foot. Five, like a tug of war between your knee and your heel. Beautiful, hands down. It's a runner stretch or a full split. You decide. Greet it and meet it with a bit of tenderness. Let ease wash over the face. So we have a core blowout and then we done. So I'll set up our timer. You stay as you are. And then, lunging into the front knee, meet me in a high plank for 1 minute. Kick out through the heels, finding the drishti or gazing point. Kick out through those heels, tuck your ribs, your lungs together. Soften what can soften, and then figure out which engagement's gonna serve you best. Like what power center, where do I wanna put my efforts? We're halfway there. I know you can't see your face, but I want it to look at ease and gentle. 10 more seconds, protract the shoulders. Find your gazing point. 4-arm side plank on your left. Drop your left forearm to the earth 1 minute. So you could drop down onto the knee. You could reach an arm up. Your eyes give direction to the pose. So if you look up, you're gonna maybe feel a bit higher. So we're 1/4 of the way there, long tailbone. Contract the side of the body. So this is the obliques. You'll notice your glutes are active. We're halfway there. Soften your eyes, soften your mouth. 10 more seconds. Beautiful, swap sides. Right forearm down, 1 minute. So modify, make it work. Again, you might notice one side is better than the other, stronger than the other, more at ease than the other. 30 more seconds, contract rib to hip. Push the earth away. More seconds. Push the floor away. 10 more seconds. We got it. We got it. Tone the glutes. Nicely done. Come through center, lower onto your belly, and roll over onto your back. Our last core exercise before Shavasana, bend your knees, bend your elbows, eagle arms and legs. Left arm under, left leg over. Inhale, pull them apart. Exhale together. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, untangle, retangle, inhale, lengthen together, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Release and lie on your back, Shavasana. Big inhale. One more. We'll be right back. Taking a deep inhale. One more. Move your fingers, move your toes. Stretch your arms long. Tuck your knees towards your belly to roll to the right. And then rise to a comfortable cross-legged seat. And close your eyes. Be embodied, present, and carry this practice throughout the day, through every interaction. And bring your hands to your heart. And bow your chin. Last moment to say thank you for this moment. And then lifting our eyes and our hearts.